Oh my goodness, that video, to be honest with you, went viral this week. And
and of course, Kemo and Stiga, mona. Bitima.
And that's what...
Kama nataka kuchukua kura. As in, that's what we are talking about today, pop culture and its influence on the elections. What women decide, they are going to use their social status, social class, to be able to endorse these people.
That's right, Asili. It's not
politicians,
just,
actually.
Yeah, it's not just that. But, you know, artists, their music's being used in rallies. Mm-hmm. On top of that, you have the likes of most of them asking, or rather participating in their rallies when they have a concert and so forth. Mm-hmm. So when you see your favorite celebrity endorsing a certain politician, does that change your way of voting? All mm-hmm. right? And that's what we're asking tonight. Does celebrity endorsement affect how you vote? Yes, no, it depends. It makes no difference. And of course, also, because we normally have two Twitter post questions, that's our leading one. Mm-hmm. Our second one, if you also want to get involved in it, is how has social media, or rather, has social media made politics better or worse? The options are better, worse, interesting. It does not make any difference. And we really, really, really want to hear from you guys on that note. There it is. Has social media made politics better or worse?
Mm-hmm.
So jump onto social media, hashtag Youth Cafe, and let's get this conversation started,
and
all right?
Of course, on our personal handles, Banani, at Brian underscore Sally.
I'm so sorry.
At Zinzi underscore K, let's continue conversing.
Fantastic. Let's introduce our panel tonight. And they are a fantastic one. Allow me to start with Edward Omondi, who is a music producer. Karibu. And Edward will really help us understand, because he's managed, rather he's worked with one of the some amazing top artists here in Kenya. When they do this, is it really genuine or is it just out of money? And then he needs no introduction. He is a musical artist, Echo Dida. Good evening.
Shambamba.
Thank you so much for coming. And Asili, who do you have next to you?
Karibu na Mrembo. Mrembo Naruto. Anaitwa Wamboi Nyutu. Did I pronounce vizuri?
Wamboi Nyutu.
Nyutu.
Yeah. Hey. Nyoto. It's supposed to be Nyoto.
It's supposed to be Nyoto.
For you, naweza kuexcuse useme Nyutu.
Nyutu and Sili.
And Wamboi is with Warembo na Uhuru Ruto, right?
Yes. Sure.
And thank you guys so much for coming this evening. We'll be expecting Philip Ogola, and when he comes, you'll join into the conversation. But let me begin with this. Echo, allow me to start with you. You're a musical artist, fantastic. I mean, your kids are also amazing.
Shukra.
Oh my gosh.
Gracia, God's officiant.
Amen. Amen. So, Echo, talk to me. What are your thoughts when you see celebrities endorsing politicians? Is that okay with you? Yes or no? Where do you stand with that?
Nasema ina depend.
Mm-hmm.
Kwa sababu kuna politicians na kuna leaders.
True.
So acha niseme kama ni just a politician, then nasema that's a no-no. But kama ni a leader, then siding with them is a yes.
Mm-hmm.
Leaders iko na qualities, leaders iko na principles. Leaders inamaanisha unaenda kuongoza watu, mm-hmm. kuenda njia fulani,
mm-hmm.
but politician ni kutafuta vibe ama hype,
kuraise
on hype na labda background yako opinion natoka watu wenyu. Mm-hmm. Si aiendanishi na uongozi,
mm-hmm.
literally. So mm-hmm. naweza sema for politicians inaweza kuwa for artists ni too bad that unaweza kuwa na this influence ama this power alafu unaitumia kupeleka kwa just a politician mwenyako ready kugamble na lives za wase na votes zao na una get na future hao.
Mimi niko na swali.
But uki side na a leader, which is msee mwenye anajua kwenye anaenda, ni msee hata mkiangalia from way back ama from start, ni mtu akona leadership capability, then I would say that's a yes, kwa sababu inamaanisha unatumia influence yako kujaribu kuelekeza wase towards nyuma ya mtu mwenye anaweza saidia future yao, ama kama ni politician MP anaenda kupitisha mikakati,
ama anaenda kupitisha mashauri kidogo niulize
zenye zitasaidia ama zita make their lives better.
Ni story tu,
exactly.
Inakuja tu sasa niulize Mr. Producer, Mr. Omondi. Wewe ni producer, umesikia kuna song imekuwa ikiimba hapo hivyo. NASA. Wewe mtu akikam studio unamwambiaje? Unamadvise? Unamuuliza kwa nini ana record hiyo song? Ama humwambia tu, wewe lete pesa ku record ni 20k ama 15k, tuunde hii song. Ama unaangalia pia venye hii song itakuwa kama influence kwa watu wenye watenda kusikiza?
Ina depend. First watch and say, ujui kwa nini yako anacheka. Kwa ajui naitwa hivyo.
Aya, tunaitwa nani?
watu wananijua kama
Dr. Eddie.
Dr. Eddie. Kwa
I don't live same even
Dr. Eddie kwa chini ya maji mazeji. Hata social media sioni picha zako
man. Sioni watu behind the scenes.
Anyway. Oh, nice.
It really depends on the content of the artist. Nini anataka kuimba na which kind of audience and target. Yeah. See, it's not just a matter of una pesa kuja to record ni hapana. But kuna songs zingine unaweza ona.
Unajua hii ni ya mkwanja, hii ni ya kunda tu doka tu.
Yeah, ni ya mkwanja but ina depend. Unajua kuna zile nyimbo wewe kwako unaweza ona si kitu that much appealing but it appeals to the masses. So.
But the thing is that you've been in this industry for quite some time. So yes. You know the business of the music industry.
Yes.
Would you advise an artist to come out and politically show their support towards a candidate in terms of brand? Because what does that do for a brand?
No, I wouldn't really support them coming out and publicly supporting a certain political side. Because first of all, it really weighs much on your brand. Yeah, the outcome of the election will really determine whether after that you will be relevant or.
Yeah.
You see, if you support a guy and he loses, you lose with him. You
so
understand?
It can backfire on an artist.
It can backfire on you. And actually, if you come out and support somebody publicly, there are people who are against this candidate. They'll automatically choose not to.
Yeah. So yeah. Somehow it affects also a
It really position. Affects, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay, Wamboi, allow me to engage you a little bit.
Sure.
Tell our audience what Warembo na Uhuru Ruto is all about.
Well, Warembo na Uhuru Ruto is a young women organization that really engages in reaching out to the young women and making sure that they actively participate in politics. Yeah, basically that is all what it is about.
But I have a question. Oh, ni kama hii politics ni already bias. Already msha side na political party. Ndio hii development itakani kama kama wewe si wa chama, mbona tu kuinvolve? Sijui kama unanipata.
You know, in politics you have to have a stand. You just can't venture into politics whereas you don't have anyone that you support or you don't have you're a watermelon, if I may use that word. And you really have to take a stand, unless maybe you are an NGO that wants to engage everyone else.
Domino
but
Lisa.
For us,
Domino Lisa, already mnakanika mko biased. You're not for the Kenyans, you're for one political party because hata wase wenye wana propagate stuff, already ni chama moja. Nasaki ku mention your chama. Of course, tumesha mention majina. Lakini, is it that you guys only care for the interest of the people who support your political party or you're dealing with, you're supporting all people, like all women?
What we want is young women to support Uhuru Ruto based actually on their scorecard, which maybe on this show I can be able to mention. They've done so much for the women. We have free maternity. We have women being given, like in our party, you realize that so many women have won seats, you know, in the nominations as MPs, as even senators, and even as governors. So I think you really need to look for a party that looks at the interest of women. You know, our president has been on the front line begging parliamentarians to implement the two-third gender rule. So we looked at a candidate who cares about us. And to us, that was Uhuru and Ruto.
And how have you used social media to pass along that message?
We are greatly on social media, like during our launch, which was in September last year, we were trending on Twitter because we realized that many young women are in social media. You get them on Twitter, you get them on Instagram, on Facebook, you know, everywhere. And so if you don't engage yourself in these platforms, then you won't be able to reach these people. So we are greatly in those ones. You can follow us at Warembo na Uhuru Ruto. Yeah,
that's it. Eko, kwa songs zako mingi usema tribe all.
I love that.
Unaget? Pop culture mazijo. Haitu allow kusikiza tu ngoma juu tu ni echo. Unaget? Hata ulichange jina yako kwa ID ni kweli. Ulichange jina yako ndio isikue affiliated kwa
tribal.
Yeah, isikue tribal at all. Wewe unasemaje? Hawa ukiona msee akiendorse kitu, do you think watu wanavoting juu wanapenda muziki yake ama kazi yake ama watu vote kwanza wanasema, "Eh, huyu jamaa anaimba poa lakini kwanza ni wa kwetu."
Yeah. Acha niseme music ni one neutral place. Mm-hmm. Unaweza ona vitu mob from angle ya ama perspective ya tribal, but music acha nikwambie hata tukiwa watu wetu kwa tunasikiza ngoma, in fact zile ngoma tulikuwa tunaimba za interclasses. Mm-hmm. Zilikuwa hata tujui zinamaanisha nini. Unaimba tu yaani mshinde, competition against the other class. Kuna ngoma fulani ya Kiluya ama ya Kikamba ama ya Kinandi, hata amjui, in fact hata hizo words amjui kama na pronounce right. Juu mwalimu pia amjui, pia hata si hiyo tribe.
Bora ina sound interesting.
Exactly. So with music inakoga one place, ina cut across, yani unajua ina cut all culture. Yani ni kama huwa gena shape culture actually. Mm-hmm. So acha niseme with an artist ku make decisions, acha niseme kusimama na chama ama nini, I think watu ushindwa kutu judge based on, in fact unaweza shangazana kupata msi bora kupua musically wasio. Mm-hmm. Hata anaweza kwa labda msi ametoka central. Mm-hmm. But anashinda hata watu wameimba na English. Mm-hmm. Yote unasikia ngoma yao. Yeah. Ukisikia kama Zahara, anaitwa Zahara, ule manzi wa South Africa.
Yeah. Loliwe.
Exactly. Hata tusikia anasema nini, but ngoma yake ilikuwa imetuingia sana.
Inashinda charts na
exactly. Anawina hata awards huku. What I get? Yeah. And so on and so forth. Yeah. So acha niseme watu wa tuvoti mostly based on your tribe. And mm-hmm. I think hapo ndio penye watu find it wrong. Unapata labda msanii ni deadly, lakini anasikia sasa unaambia sasa since umeet sana, sasa imba ya kikwetu sasa uone venye tutakununulia hizo CD and all that. So to cut the long story short, naweza sema mimi personally take yangu ni since people don't vote for us based on our tribes kwa awards. Mm-hmm. Nizo places zingine people actually come kwa awards bila kulipo, in fact most of them pay hata kwa show concerts, it's them who pay, not us.
Lakini wewe ukisimama hivi useme yeah. Mzee wa chama fulani, mzee wa chama fulani unamsupport. Si wewe unaona ni kama watu wengi watakusupport, watasupport wata you mzee just because Eko amesema.
Yeah. Hiyo ina happen a lot.
Yeah.
See we influence decision za acha niseme
my youth
ama decisions za raia, hata si my youth peke yake. Mm-hmm. Raia. Mm-hmm. Generally since mtu ana kuna zile values tuko nazo, kuna venye ukiangalia, acha nipatie example na Bob Marley. Ukiangalia Jamaicans, kuna time kulikuwa kunaenda kuwa na war. Mm-hmm. ya story la politics. The moment alirudi kutoka, na alikuwa short, yani jewe story ya politics, when mm-hmm. he came back, ilibaki Jamaica mzima, hiyo tu kubringa leaders pamoja kwa shikanisha mikono. Mm-hmm. Kulikuwa na peace. Mm-hmm. Just because by the virtue of, he's an artist,
yeah.
So he's neutral.
Yeah. Echo, but let me ask you, you haven't done any specific song for any specific candidate or any specific party. Mm-hmm. But within your circles, within your industry, your umbrella, do you think when artists, because like you said, they have an influence, when artists come out and support a political candidate, e.g. allowing their music to be aired during their rallies or going to perform during their launches, do you think that the artists are being genuine, that yes, I am endorsing this candidate because I believe in what they stand for, or is it all just about the money?
I think jani sema hapa ukweli ni raia kubwa jo kwenye jo ju Kenya watu wako njaa wengi ndio mayutma. So watu kufia wala kukufia timu na kufia mfuko unajua.
Yeah.
So most of the artists acha niseme wao panda two stage jua hiyo fact ya pesa, but reality ni personally na yeye ino stand yangu from kitambo, from way back. Kama si oni vision yako as a politician ikiambatana na my type of politics ya leadership, I won't come hata kuna nipatia dunia mzima, because truth be told, after that kuna life.
Yes. And Dr. Eddie, what do you think about it? Are the artists being genuine, or is it just about the money?
Mostly it's about the money, I would say that.
Yeah.
Actually, most of the time, it's just about the money.
Yeah.
Because if you call me to perform at your rally, it doesn't really mean I have to endorse you to perform at the rally. You understand? Mm-hmm. It's just like, I'll say it's just like any other business. Mm. Yes. If a political party takes an advert to standard media, doesn't mean the standard media endorses that person. It's about the money. Mm-hmm. So if you call me and pay me to perform on your platform, I can't perform on your platform.
Exactly. Tutendelea na hiyo point tukirudi. Lakini each and every week we go to the city streets, different city streets. Last week nilisema tulienda Nairobi na tulikuwa Mombasa. This week tuko Tanzania na Rwanda. Let's get to hear. Let's listen to some of the things that they had to say on this topic today.
Wasanii wana mchango mkubwa sana kufanikisha wale viongozi wa ngazi ya juu kabisa kuwa madarakani. Kutokana na nini? Na tunapozungumzia kampeni, kampeni ni ubunifu. Msanii akisema kwamba kitu fulani tufanye au kitu fulani mchague mtu fulani inakuwa mtu ana urahisi mkubwa sana tofauti na mtu wa kawaida tu.
Msanii kama msanii ana fan base kubwa kuliko mtu kama mimi ambaye naweza nikashawishi watu wawili akapiga kura, lakini msanii ana zaidi ya watu 1000 kwenda kupiga kura.
Tunaangalia katika vyombo vya habari kama hivi ya kwao wanakuwa wana support kubwa utushawishi sisi kupiga kura.
I may love someone's actions but not actually loving what she or he does during the voting.
So when someone is your role model, so I don't see anyhow you can't follow his footsteps when he has chosen to support any of the presidential candidates. That's why for me I believe it does affect very much.
People imitate. You imitate because he's your role model. So they are convincing people who follow them.
I think it does to a smaller extent though, because there's this time when the youth, especially when they like so into an artist, a celebrity, they kind of want to be like them. They want to imitate them. So everything they do, they try to imitate them. So
Harvey. And I think the youth and they take him as their candidate as well.
Echo, what do you think? Celebrity investment does not work. Kenyans are becoming more independent minded.
Yeah, independent or not, najua ukweli ni kuna raia ana idhaa ya kusikiza politics hata dakika sumuni. News huanza kama change. Ana idhaa ya kusikia kuhusu gazeti sijini hata wasomaki. Yani yeye anapoangalia huku kuangalia ball. Ama kuangalia katikati kuna pals msanii nini. So ukweli ni nawaambia from mimi mwenyewe ndiko mmoja wasi unajua. So representing the others wenye ni wengi, by default kuna ule msanii mwenye unajua anaongeanga sense. Ukisikia kuna side amendos ama kuna point amesema about a certain politician, by default utataka kusupport huo mzee. Full stop. Waga tu nani alisema? Umesikia nani alisema nini? Mm. Alisema huu ndio leader. So on that note unaona na sisitiza wasanii pia usirukie tu stage juu kuna pesa. Unapoteza ule kijana na ule kijana ni yako innocent. So afadhali ukata hiyo do but make future room say brighter. Assume one bro wako fulani.
Don't you not think then their followers, because as much as I love your music or this musician and they decide to support this candidate, political candidate, whom I do not think we share a vision with, as a Kenyan, you know, don't I not have the responsibility to question, to read, to understand? So even though my favorite artist says, you know what, I support candidate X, I'll be like, I'm a big fan of you, but when it comes to politics, we may not see eye to eye. I might still enjoy your music, but when it comes to politics, we are on different levels. So don't you not think the youth should be challenged to them being more aware, reading more, than just following blindly?
By the way, I think, chaniseme, kuna pia wengi sana, wenye, kwanza wa Kenya ni watu wa sharp sana. Wa ghetto kwanza ni wa sharp sana. Mtoto angalia aseme, hapa jo Echo alipandeo stage, juu kuna do. Ukweli ni hata Echo labda atapigia huyo mwanasiasa kura. So Wakenya ni wa sharp sana.
Wezi watupisha mbao.
Wanajua hata unasikia ngo kisema, huyu ndo anatuchocha huyu msanii. Hapa hizi malyrics jo hapa ametuenjoy. So they don't just follow things blindly.
Dr. Eddie, on your comment on the issue that Kenyans are becoming more independent minded.
I'll beg to differ. Majority of the people who vote don't really, they go by hearsay, they go by what they hear people say. Or from what region I come from, this is my guy, comes from our place. That's what they base on. So endorsements don't really change much. Me kama msani, if I endorse somebody, the pattern of voting for Kenyans is different. Maybe in other enlightened worlds, maybe in the US, it would change something. Because you remember in 2008.
Yeah. What Oprah Winfrey endorsed Obama, it went crazy.
He added 1 million votes to his you see. Mm. Yeah, but for Kenyans, no, I don't really think.
You don't think so?
I don't really
kuna,
think.
Kuna kitu moja nimeona na wasanii sana. Na some few years back. Ata uneza be a witness na vitu kama hizi. Eko, kuna time uliunda I am Kenyan.
Yeah.
It was a concert where you called all Kenyans, wakakam, tukaka chini, wase wakaimba, the whole day. True. You likamo Kenyan. True. But kuna events zingine zinaka, okay, ni political rally, mse ame decide, kama venye Bahati alikam, akajipox kwa kiti ya prezo, vitukaa hizo. Kuna drama mobi you happen, but kile najaribu kusema, uyo msanii hata labda yuko affiliated to that political party. Yeah. Lakini umeitwa unatafuta money, unatafuta do. Sindio? Umekamu perform your stage, alafu kila mtu anaanza kusema, Eko alikuwa kwa hiyo stage, anasupport huyo msi. Swali yangu tu ni moja. Unafikiria kuna msanii mwenye anaezenda tu gig, achape gig kama akili yake iko fixed kwa hiyo msi mwenye wa hiyo political party, ama yuko in support of labda philosophies of hiyo political party.
But they are wasanii wengi sana wanafanya hivyo. Kwa sababu acha niseme due to hiyo kukosa kakitu kwa mfuko, jo unasikia ma echo kwa mfuko sana. Society jo venye iko, acha niseme na unaona ndio kuna hizo issues mob sana, unapata labda hata mayuto anaguzishwa kakitu, unaguzishwa jill, ama host, unapiga nduru the whole day ukisema nani tosha, unajua? So society venye iko, acha niseme kuna shida mahali. Watu wamesota sana, ni kuna venye pesa iko. Kuna route zenye zinajua zinaishianga sasa na raia. So ikikuja kwa situation kama hizo unapata kuna msi hata ajabai hata ajio msi alisikia tu simu jo kuna pesa ya rais hapa. Unajua kuja tukule. So same way unapata mafans kuja na pesa ya rais pajero iko hapa jo tupige nduru tuimbe msi alafu hata tutavutia msi. Tunasimulia chali na tukata tupisha mbao. The same crew ndio imeenda kwa hilo ringine mpya MP mwingine atakao. Same crew imechukua hizo t-shirt kazi yake kwa mfuko ule mwingine akitokea. So acha niseme Kenyans by then wise. Ndio atakuja tukichekeshe artist wengi watakuja upande stage waimbe and wakufurahishe but hata hujabai polisi yako. Na hata atakuvutia by the. In fact hata labda juji na yako. Huyo msi amepanda stage lakini juu hata jina yao politician.
Dr. Eddie was laughing when he asked that comment. Dr. Eddie was laughing. I really want to hear from him before you ask Mwamboi.
Si ni kweli?
No, it's true. It's all about the money.
It's all about the money. I mean, if my eyes will be fixed on the check, yeah, what is the figure down there?
But what if it's at the expense of your brand?
That's why I'm saying you don't come out publicly to declare I support this guy.
So I can then perform at a concert, but I don't come out publicly and still say...
Yeah. If you don't come out publicly to support this guy, then it makes no difference. I'll come, I'm an entertainer. I'm coming to entertain people.
Which is weird.
But isn't that
which
lying to Kenyans?
It's very weird.
Isn't actually, that not lying to Kenyans?
Actually, see at a lying. It's I can't say many kama ni crime. Ni kukosa kujijua.
A difference ni, you guys don't really know. If you call me to entertain, I'll come do my work as an entertainer. You understand? Yeah, you're calling me to call people for you. Whatever you're telling those people, I don't care. I'm here, you paid me to entertain these people and get a crowd for you.
Take yangu for that is a no. Unafakwana principles. Unafakwana principles. Nika kusema ati, tuseme, tunataka kuorganize watu waibiwe wengi, eh? So, madingo, ama AKA wezi waite msanii fulani akuja apige tukuite upige show wewe msanii upige show right usitakulipa lakini bora crowd ikuje kubwa alafu tuwalipue ama tuwafanye kitu ndio poa ndio yani tupate crowd kubwa pia
hata ni mwanzo point yangu
I think as an individual as an artist that hiyo ni acha niseme it's a very weird personality. Unafaa kwa zile za wait ni kazi gani nakuja kufanya hapo principles zenyu ni gani so sitakuja tu kwa show ati juu itanipay hata kama after hapo hiyo crowd yote itakuja itasaksuliwa mifuko
na na story imeshika sana lakini nataka udema nasemaje
I think as an entertainer you're not supposed to discriminate on your crowd. If you're called to entertain people kwa rally ya Rao, just go there and do your job. If you're called to Uhuru's, go there and do your job. But when it comes to endorsing candidates, endorse that candidate who you believe in. True. Na ule mtu unajua ati naenda zuyo mtu because I believe in his principles and in his agenda.
But at the same time...
Before you finish your point, then you can jump in.
At the same time, I believe that as Kenyans, we need to grow, you know, mm-hmm. to grow and at least appreciate that si lazima huyu msanii, he's human like me, and mm-hmm. they need to participate in politics as well. Mm-hmm. So nafani jue ati akiendoz Uhuru, ama akiendoz Raila, si ati nafani mchukie kuza memuendoz,
true.
You know. Mm-hmm.
True.
Yeah, we need to really move on from that and we'll be able to discern. Yes, I'm a Windows, but for me, I can't vote for them. But see, I didn't touch your music yake just because of that.
Eko, what was your comment?
Look, when I say, as an artist, upendo zipende by default, by the fact that umepanda hiyo stage, unakwangu Windows. Upendo zipende. Mm-hmm. Upendo zipende. By default, ni kama uwe ende Safaricom na tisho ya Airtel.
And you're a Safaricom worker.
No, you're a Safaricom, actually.
Umeendoze,
upendo zipende.
Umeenda kusaka deal, hapo hivyo umepoteza.
Exactly, it's simple and clear. People, what was you are blind? What one is a tell to you, say the fact that I'm panda stage, and I support each other. So, most likely, una mislead wa see. If it's someone that auamini, au kubaliani na leadership skills zake ni nini,
ukipandeo stage, una mislead watu. All over, you know,
jumping
from one
camp.
Politician
exactly.
to another, and it doesn't
Which is
affect
wrong.
Their music.
It doesn't affect their music.
I don't think it's wrong because their role is to entertain.
I would want to say something. I would want to say something.
We should be principled.
Yes.
Where are our principles?
But what I will say is, akuna politician atasimama pale without what he wants to say, which is good. You understand?
Okay.
Okay. In a way that you when you come there, you are automatically endorsing. Each political party have an agenda for the people.
Let me try and maybe shift their perspective to yours to help you, let's see if you can understand this. What if tomorrow Uhuru and Ruto come out and say they have a few points that really doesn't fit well with the female numbers, all right? Mm-hmm. You guys as Warembo wa Uhuru na Ruto, will you stand up and say, we disagree with this, but because you guys are still supporters of Uhuru Ruto, you know, you campaigned for them, yeah. you will still stand behind them, even though you know that their pointers on women are, not friendly.
Yeah, you understand that we are there basically because we're women and because we support them because of the agenda they have for women. So if they seem to deviate from that, we will definitely come out and tell them that, we were supporting you because you had an agenda for us, the women, but now
but
that you
when
have... Now that you have taken a different stand,
yes.
we really cannot support you and you have to change this.
Mm-hmm.
But, that's it. But for music, mm-hmm. Their role is to entertain.
No,
should you discriminate
on
a crowd?
I'm just trying to step us up. We are beyond mm-hmm. your time when musicians were just entertainers. Mm-hmm. We are beyond your time when your footballers were just entertainers. Mm-hmm. Nowadays, footballers speak. Didier Drogba aliongea Ivory Coast. Ivory Coast hiyo vita ilikuenda kwanza kazima. So wewe kama unafikiria, kama ni kijana unafikiria from your line we are just entertainers. Mm-hmm. I think we may lose.
No, that is why I separated the two. I said if you're going to entertain, go and entertain. But if you're going to endorse, only endorse the candidate who you believe in who you know has the agenda.
This conversation is something else. And even online, it's something else different. Let me read Manuela's tweet. He says, celebrity endorsement in politics affects voting pattern. There is nothing wrong if you endorse a politician. And that's what we're asking you guys today. When a celebrity endorses as politician, does that affect how you vote? Especially the young voters, the millennials. Yes, no, it depends. It makes no difference. And of course, our other question was has social media made politics better or worse? Better is one of the options. Worse is the other option. Interesting and makes no difference. We'll hear from our panel when you come back. But right now, it is time for Ad Corner. And Brian Asili met, one of the most amazing choir members, the man behind Red Fourth Choir. Take a look.
I fell in love with music early in my life, singing in the family altars. But now when I got to about 12 years old is when I was involved, I was part of a Christmas production in church. Now, that's when now I felt that, hey, I actually love how harmony works, and we were part of a choir. I think that was the first time that I was involved in a choir.